This is my 1986 Yamaha Phaser, and it's got the same issue that a lot of old Yamahas have. Loose steering problem. Yeah, it's pretty bad on this one, and it gets bad on a lot of old Yamahas. So if you have an old Yammy with the floppy steering going in the front end, we're going to try something to try to remedy that. I'll put the part number in the description, as I think that this kit applies to a lot of old Yamaha sleds, not just the 86 Phaser that we're going to be working on today. This kit snugs up that extra space between the bushings, making all these fittings a little bit tighter in the steering system. I'm not going to be doing new bushings anywhere on this thing. I do recommend that you should replace all the bushings, but I'm just going to be doing the fixed kit, and I'll do the tie rod ends as well. So even if our bushings are shot, I'm curious to see how good of a job that this fixed kit for Yamaha loose steering really is. There's a lot of moving parts in the steering system, which means that there's a lot of joints. So even if each joint just has a little bit of play in it throughout every single link, that can lead to a very, very floppy feel in the steering. I'm gonna go ahead and do this repair now. Basically anywhere in that steering system that I can put a shim, I'm gonna be putting one in, and we'll see what it looks like when it's all done. I think I'm only gonna end up using actually a few shims out of this kit. I found in my sled is that the worst of it was actually just a couple of the fittings. Okay, I got the phaser all assembled, all back together, all the steering parts done. So this is the result. And this is from that shim kit and a couple of tie rod ends. The links on this unit tightened up really nice with that shim kit, as well as there was some loose hardware that I tightened up, and I'm noticing a big difference. There is still some play in that steering. I didn't expect that kit to fix all of it, but the play in the steering is now what I'd call like a normal acceptable play. That's pretty normal, especially when we consider checking out some of our other sleds in the fleet. Turbo Cat, White Knight, the M Series with the Ski-Doo hood sitting on it. And then of course the Race Summit sitting way back here. So the result there was positive. It took out a lot of the steering play. It took it down to what I would say like a normal amount is. I used very little of those shims. If you have a sled with like trailing arms or A-arm kits, because this is like a Yamaha bushing kit, you'll end up using a lot more of those shims. I only ended up using them in a few places, but the places I did use it actually made quite a big difference. I'll get this motor put in. I assume by the time you see this video, the motor will already be in. The last video I spend here with the phaser will be odds and ends. If you have a Yammy with loose steering, hopefully today's video helped you out a little bit. I wanted to install a kit because I'd never seen anybody do it before. But my camera's just about out of memory here. So thanks everybody for watching. If you enjoyed this video, hit the subscribe button down below. We're working on sleds because there's no snow. So this is what we're doing for now. But we are going out right away riding. We might even be doing it by the time you see this video. Thanks everybody for watching. 3 seconds, I gotta go. Bye!